السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، نحمدك اللهم سبحانك كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك. نحمدك اللهم آناء الليل وأطراف النهار معترفين بسلطانك، حامدين شاكرين لنعمائك. ندعو الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يديم علينا نعمه ظاهرة وباطنة، وأن يلهمنا العزم والعزيمة والصبر والثبات على أن نحمده على تلك النعمة. اللهم آمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يحيي ويميت وهو حي لا يموت، وهو على كل شيء قدير، شهادة قامت بها السماوات والأرض. ندعو الله سبحانه وتعالى ألا يحرمنا إياها لحظة لقائه، اللهم أمين. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. اللهم اجزه عنا خير ما تجزي به مرسلا ونبيا. اللهم شفعه فينا شفاعة لا نعذب بعدها أبدا. اللهم اسقنا من حوضه شربة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا، اللهم أمين. محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم طب القلوب ودواؤها، وعافية الأبدان وشفاؤها، ونور الأبصار وضياؤها. صلى عليك الله يا علم الهدى، ما هبت النسائم وما ناحت على الأيك الحمائم. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, our sons and daughters, the future of Islam, wonderful people, friends all over the world who have been watching our Friday sermon live through the internet, through the Facebook. جزاكم الله خيرا، جزاكم الله خيرا. لازلنا مع الحبيب المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم، نسمع ونرى ونقرأ ما قاله عنه غير المسلمين من كتاب ومؤرخين، من ألفوا عنه ومن كتبوا عنه ومن أرادوا أن يدلوا بما فهموا عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And I'm not saying we're still learning from them, but we are kind of really trying to understand what non-Muslims said about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Historian, writers, authors of all over the world, Orientalists, and we have you, many of them. Today, inshallah, we'll focus on what that French author, المفكر الفرنسي أستاذ لوبون روبرتسون، أستاذ لوبون روبرتسون، what did he say about Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم؟ And we'll shed some lights on what Islam said in regards to what he said, in order to have some comments very similar to what he said, very similar to what he shared with us, in order to find out also what Islam is saying about what those writers or thinkers, especially the French ones said about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to send that very 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 clear message to the French, quote unquote, leadership, understand Muhammad, who is, from your own people, not necessarily to read the Quran, not necessarily to read the revelation, the wahi of Allah to the Prophet of Islam, not necessarily to study the biography, the seerah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or his sunnah, his tradition sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Read what your own people said about him صلى الله عليه وسلم. يقول المفكر الفرنسي المعروف غوستاف لوبون روبرتسون، إن مسامحة محمد لليهود والنصارى كانت عظيمة للغاية، وأن المسلمين وحدهم جمعوا بين الغيرة لدينهم وروح التسامح نحو أتباع الديانات الأخرى. That statement from Gustave Le Bon. saying that definitely, certainly, without any doubt, Muhammad was tolerant and forgivable to the Jews and the Christians. It was tremendous. It was good. It was great. And I would say that Muslims only, meaning following the teaching of Allah, the teaching of Quran, and the teaching of the Sunnah, the tradition of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, were the only people, who do have that dedication to their deen, and in the meantime, that spirit of forgiving those who follow some other religions. Very fair statement, and very nice statement, very good. And I would say mainly that French thinker Gustave Le Bon Robertson took those teachings from the sources of Islam. He did not get it from anywhere else, but he get it from especially the Quran, get it from the ayah in Surah Al-Mumtahina, and I'm sure he studied those ayat of the Quran really well. Otherwise, he won't say what he is saying. Surah Al-Mumtahina, ayah 8, لَا يَنْهَاكُمُ اللَّهُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ لَمْ يُقَاتِلُوكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ وَلَمْ يُخْرِجُوكُمْ مِنْ دِيَارِكُمْ أَنْ تَبَرُّوهُمْ وَتُقْسِطُوا إِلَيْهِمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ. This is the ayah. Gustave Le Bon is heavily dependent on saying what he said. Allah does not forbid, addressing Muslims, of course, Allah does not forbid you to deal justly and kindly with those who fought not against you on account of religion, nor drove you out of your homes. Verily, Allah loves those who deal with equity. Those historians, those writers, in whatever they wrote down about Muhammad, it was in their own thinking. Yani statement coming out of their mind and say it haphazardly. No, they were heavily dependent on what they have studied about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and about Islam as well. That's why when you look at their statement, very precise, very accurate, because they studied Quran and the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam before what they said about him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the ayah number 9 in Surah Al-Mumtahina, chapter 60, إِنَّمَا يَنْهَاكُمُ اللَّهُ عَنِ الَّذِينَ قَاتَلُوكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ وَأَخْرَجُوكُمْ مِنْ دِيَارِكُمْ وَظَاهَرُوا عَلَىٰ إِخْرَاجِكُمْ أَنْ تَوَلُّوهُمْ وَمَنْ يَتَوَلَّهُمْ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. This is the second ayah. Here, Gustave is heavily dependent on giving what he said or saying what he said about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is only as regards those who fight against you on the account of religion and have driven you out of your homes and helped to drive you to befriend them, that Allah forbids you to befriend them, and whosoever will befriend them, then such are the zalimun, wrongdoers, those who disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Thinking about what he said and thinking about what the Quran is saying, there is no discrepancy, no difference whatsoever, except this is coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his revelation, in his wahi to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is what this writer, Gustave Le Bon Robertson, is saying about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi وسلم. That's why we have to understand that البر والقسط مطلوبان من المسلم تجاه كل الناس ما لم يقفوا في وجهه ويضطهدوا أهله. يعني righteousness and justice are very very highly recommended for Muslims to stick to and to abide by from the Muslimun, from the Muslims toward all people. It doesn't matter who they are, what they believe in. All people, it does not matter, except when they are, of course, fighting the Muslims and stand against them and oppress them and suppress them. ولأهل الكتاب من بين غير المسلمين منزلة خاصة في المعاملة. فالقرآن ينهى عن مجادلتهم كما ذكرنا في الآية الكريمة في سورة الممتحنة إلا بالحسنى ويبيح مؤاكلتهم والأكل من ذبائحهم ومصاهرتهم وهذا هو أصل التسامح. The people of the book, here we're talking about Yahud and Nasara. They do have some specific status among Muslims in dealing with them and in relationship with them. We have seen that Quran is totally forbidden anything done wrong toward them, and we deal with them with the best way ever, with the best way ever. How Quran is really giving us the permission to eat from them, their food, and to marry from them. Of course, men, Muslims marry non-Muslim ladies, Christian or Jew. And this is, as a matter of fact, the essence and the principles of being tolerant to them and being decent to them and forgiving them. ولأهل الذمة في دار الإسلام حق الحماية من كل عدوان خارجي ومن كل ظلم داخلي. This is what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is teaching us, that about the people of the book living with us. They do have the right to be protected from any external enemies or any external aggression about them, and any oppression or suppression would be implemented on them. This is our duty toward them. دماء أهل الذمة وأنفسهم وأموالهم وأعراضهم معصومة باتفاق المسلمين وقتلهم حرام. The blood of the people of the book here and themselves and their money and their wealth and those who are related to them are totally 100% protected as has been agreed upon among Muslims. And of course, killing them is a sin, is totally forbidden, is totally forbidden. If we move forward to see what Gustave Le Bon Robertson said also about Islam and about Muslims, where he said that wonderful statement, صان الإسلام لغير المسلمين معابدهم وشعائرهم وكل ما يطلبه الإسلام من غير المسلمين أن يراعوا مشاعر المسلمين. Islam has protected non-Muslims throughout the history. Look at it carefully. Don't bring those who pretend they were Muslims and they really suppressed non-Muslims. Here we're talking about Muslim rulers who are following Al-Kitab wa Sunnah, the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What they have done with non-Muslims, especially when it comes to their places of worship, the synagogues and the churches. Totally, 100% protected by Muslims. Protected by Muslims. And what Islam would be actually requiring from non-Muslims, here we're talking about Al-Yahud or Nasara, just to keep in mind the feelings of the Muslims, how they behave, how they relate to each other, what they are doing, and so on and so forth. Full understanding of who Muslims are. By having this full understanding, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يعني, would enable them to deal with Muslims in a good way, as Muslims have been dealing with them in a good way. And Gustave Le Bon is going on to say, إِنَّ مُسَامَحَةَ مُحَمَّدٍ لِلْيَهُودِ وَالنَّصَارَ كَانَتْ عَظِيمَةً لِلْغَايَةِ. Tolerance and forgiving and supporting of the Prophet of Islam Muhammad to the Jewish people and to the Christian people was the greatest ever to see throughout the history of mankind. This is his testimony. This is what he's saying. So when we find some other people, French people, without mentioning any names, are treating Muslims in their land in a very nasty way. And by the way, you know, the second largest Muslim population in Europe is in France, and the first one is in Germany. But look how Germany is treating Muslims and how the so-called leaders of French nowadays have been treating Muslims and also referring to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How and what they said about him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and consequently how they have been dealing with Muslims. If there is anyone who's against the law of the land, bring him to justice. No doubt about it. No doubt about it. We're not against that. But as long as they are peaceful, as long as they are working so hard, as long as they are dedicated to the laws of the land, they got to be respected. They got to be respected. إن المسلمين لبون still talking وحدهم جمعوا بين الغيرة لدينهم وروح التسامح نحو أتباع الديانات الأخرى. They are the only ones who do have that protecting their deen and working so hard to their deen, and in the meantime very tolerant, very forgivable to people who are following the other religion. But listen to that one just as a follow-up to what Le Bon is saying when it comes to positions to work within the Muslim state. وَلِأَهْلِ الذِّمَّةِ الْحَقُّ فِي تَوَلِّي وَظَائِفِ الدَّوْلَةِ كَالْمُسْلِمِينَ. إذا تحققت فيهم شروط الكفاية والأمانة والإخلاص. يا الله. You came up with this and you realize this and you understand this after studying the life of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and the teaching of Islam. People of the book do have the absolute right to have specific positions within the Muslim state. Go read the Spanish history, and how many non-Muslims were holding very sensitive positions in the state. And throughout the history of mankind, if there is non-Muslim who is qualified to hold a specific position to serve Muslims and non-Muslim alike, he is or she is or they are hired. As long as, here are the conditions the non-Muslims would have if they got to be hired within the Muslim state. These conditions, al-kifaya, wal-amana, wal-ikhlas. They are qualified to those positions. This is very obvious. In a position, if you're not qualified, you cannot be hired. You cannot be hired. If you do not have the requirements for this job to be fulfilled, you cannot hire. So al-kifaya. Wal-amana, honesty. It's a human factor. It's a human value to be honest, whether you are a Muslim or non-Muslim, Christian, a Jew, whoever you are, as long as anta aminun, you are honest, you do have the right to be hired and have a position within the Muslim state. The third condition, al-ikhlas, the sincerity. If you are sincere in what you're doing, if you're 100% devoted to the job you're doing, and as long as you're hired to perform a specific task and duties, anta mukhlas, you are sincere. You do all of them without any question. As long as you have those three conditions, if you are a non-Muslim, you could be hired and you can perform and you can contribute to the welfare of that state you're living in. And a lot of people would be wondering if that's exactly consistent, the teaching of Islam, teaching of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, consistent with those thinker, those historian, that one like Gustave Le Bon Robertson saying, how much did it take them to study Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? How much of understanding they do have about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and how they are brave enough to tell us more and more and more about Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We should feel ashamed as Muslims if we do not learn more and more about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We should learn more and more and more from Islam, from Quran, from the Sunnah, as well as we learn from them their testimony about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. لا زلنا في رحاب المصطفى البر لا يبلى والذنب لا ينسى والديان لا يموت كل ابن آدم خطاء وخير الخطائين التوابون والتائبون الذنب كمن لا ذنب له ادعوا الله وأنتم موقنون بالإجابة وصلوا على نبيكم ورسولكم وشفيعكم ومصطفاكم محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ادعوا الله. الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأصلي وأسلم على رسول الله صلاة وتسليما يليقان بالحبيب المصطفى النبي المجتبى صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وتابعيه وتابعي تابعيه إلى يوم الدين. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, our sons and daughters, the future of Islam, wonderful friends all over the world in thousands who have been watching the Friday sermon live through the internet. Jazakumullahu khairan. مع من تكلموا عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. With those who are writing and explaining and sharing with us something about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and there are many. So far, we have viewed about 41 of them. The last one we're talking about today is that French writer Gustave Le Bon Robertson, what he said about Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And also, we share with you the sources he read and he understood in order to tell us something about him, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. تتجلى سماحة الإسلام في معاملة الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم لأهل الكتاب يهودا كانوا أو نصارى، فقد كان صلى الله عليه وسلم يزورهم ويكرمهم ويحن إليهم ويعود مرضاهم ويأخذ منهم ويعطيهم. If that was رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم in dealing and in relationship with the Yahud and Nasara, with the Jewish people and the Christian people. To show how tolerant Islam is, how great Islam is, how much of forgiven Islam would have to those people of the book. What he said, what he did, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, visiting with them, at what he used to do, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, visiting with them and honor them and always like to relate to them, visit their patients, anyone sick of the people of the book, he would go and visit them, take from them whatever they allow him to take and give them whatever he can give them. And I'm related to this. Today, the 25th of December, what they call it, the Christmas day or the Christmas time or the New Year. Do we recognize this? It is not part of our belief, of course. And there is even a doubt about that Christmas celebrations and so on and so forth. But anyhow, they do celebrate it, and they do celebrate the New Year. And you do have a Christian around you. What you tell him? Happy New Year. Wish him the best. Show him that tolerance of Islam. So show him the goodness of Islam. Show him how you do as a human being relate to another human being. If you do this, and I'm sure, you know, beginning of Ramadan, during Ramadan, in Eid al-Fitr, in Eid al-Adha, in any celebration would have, he would do the same, because he learned from you, because you started first, and you relate to him or them first. They would do the same thing, you know. The Jewish people do have some celebration as well. Wish them the best, you know, as long as they are not fighting you, they are not ridiculing you, they are not oppressing you, and so on and so forth. This actually would develop that a human relationship between you and them, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to do. Once, subhanallah, marrat bihi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam janaza, fawakafa laha. فقيل له إنها جنازة يهودي فقال عليه الصلاة والسلام أليست نفسا. Once he was sitting with his Sahaba رضوان الله عليهم أجمعين with his companion, and a janaza, a dead person was carried by his own people, just passed by while Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم was sitting with his companion. He stood up to the janazah. Of course, the Sahaba were kind of shocked or surprised, and they asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that it is a janazah for a Jewish guy, janazah to Yahudi. Look at the answer of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He didn't say, yeah, all right, just sit down. You don't care about what's going on. You don't care about what's happening and so on and so forth. No, no, no. one statement, أليست نفسا, isn't he a human being, صلى الله عليه وسلم يا رسول الله, أليست نفسا, meaning isn't he a human being, Allah سبحانه وتعالى has created him, regardless to the religion he believe in, whether a Jew or Christian, whatever, أليست نفسا. صلى الله عليه وسلم, يعني when you learn a lot from him, especially in a situation when he have the power, when he has the authority, when he can do with non-Muslim, kafir, non-believer, disbelievers, if he give the order for all of them to be killed, they would be killed in a matter of no time. You remember that situation in Fath Mecca, the conquest of Mecca, when he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went there in order to regain Mecca at the 8th year after Hijrah, after 21 years of struggling for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, 13 years in Mecca when he had to leave it with his sahaba to Al-Madina, 8 years in Al-Madina, live there in Al-Madina, never be able to enter Mecca even for Hajj or Umrah. The 8th year now with his sahaba Ridwanullah alayhim ajma'in, he is in Mecca. يعني when they asked him, ماذا أنت فاعل بنا يا محمد, what are you going to do with us, they are helpless, they are hopeless, they are defeated, they cannot fight back, they see Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and his companions with him, they cannot do nothing. What he said صلى الله عليه وسلم, لا تثريب عليكم اليوم, لا تثريب عليكم اليوم, no blame will be on you today, we cannot hold you accountable for what you have done in the past, اذهبوا فأنتم الطلقاء, you go, you're free, you have my word, we're not gonna do anything, till the point one of the leaders of the Muslims, of the Sahaba رضوان الله عليهم أجمعين, when he declared out loud, telling Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and telling the Sahaba and telling those Quraysh people, اليوم يوم الملحمة, today is the day of revenge, we can kill as many as we can, as they did against us. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم answered him, لا, اليوم يوم المرحمة, today is the day of mercy, today is the day of mercy, not the day of fighting, not the day of killing, not the day of torturing. اذهبوا فأنتم الطلقاء, ومن دخل بيت أبو سفيان هو آمن, ومن دخل بيته فهو آمن. If you choose to enter the house of Abu Sufyan, you're safe and secure. If you stay in your house, you're safe and secure. This is the beauty of the teaching of Islam, صلى الله عليه وسلم. يعني, it's teaching us that he totally forget and forgive any bad doing the Quraysh people did against Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم and the Sahaba. And he actually go beyond this, whatever they plan to do against him صلى الله عليه وسلم, of killing and torturing and confiscating their money and their wealth and so on and so forth. What would be one of the worst situation ever than he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam seeing his uncle Hamza when his belly was totally severely open and they did with him the very nasty things, the very nasty things. Easily for him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to seek revenge and do much worse than what they did for Hamza radiallahu anhu wa ardaha. But he remembered the ayah, إِنْ عَاقَبْتُمْ فَعَاقِبُوا بِثْلِ مَا عُقِبْتُمْ بِهِ وَلَئِنْ صَبَرْتُمْ لهو خير للصابرين. Someone has afflicted or reflected a severe punishment on you, you can just respond the same, not more, not less. But if you're patient enough, it would be much better for you. This is what those Orientalists, what, you know, those people who learn about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, telling us about him, telling us about him. Why? Because mainly they are studying the Quran really, really, really carefully, the wahi of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they have learned as much as they can from the teaching of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in order for them to see how Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was behaving, what he did and what he said and what he do. Just one ayah to mention in order to conclude with this topic, inshallah rabbil alameen, how much they learn from it and how much they relate to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in what they said in a very precise way, very elegant way, very good way, talking about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, those non-Muslims, Orientalists, and writers, and historian, all of them. They were heavily dependent on that ayah of the Quran in Surah Al-Ankabut, chapter 29, ayah 46. The ayah is very clear. وَلَا تُجَادِلُوا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ إِلَّا بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْهُمْ وَقُولُوا آمَنَّا بِالَّذِي أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْنَا وَأُنْزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ وَإِلَهُنَا وَإِلَهُكُمْ وَاحِدٌ وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُسْلِمُونَ. This is what they learn in order to write about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is what we should learn in order to learn from them and behave like them and deal with people like them, especially us living here in this country, in the United States of America, or living in a European country, or living in a non-Muslim country. Stick to this ayah in order to know how to deal with the people of the book, in order to live a safe life, a good life, productive life, respectful life. You develop a great relationship with people. This is what is needed from us now, wallahi, more than ever. More than ever, we have to learn this. And argue not with the people of the scripture, Jews and Christians, unless it be in a way that is better, with good words and good manner, inviting them to Islamic monotheism with his verses, except with such of them as do wrong, and say to them, we believe in that which has been revealed to us and revealed to you, our Allah God, and your Allah God is one, it is Allah, and to him we have submitted as Muslim. وَلَا تُجَادِلُوا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ إِلَّا بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْهُمْ وَقُولُوا آمَنَّا بِالَّذِي أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْنَا وَأُنْزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ وَإِلَهُنَا وَإِلَهُكُمْ وَاحِدٌ وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُسْلِمُونَ. الله أكبر. If the non-Muslim, those writers and historians and Orientalists understood this ayah and compliment us Muslims in following this ayah, non-Muslims, as if they are reminding us, follow Islam, follow what Quran is saying, follow what the Sunnah, tradition of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is teaching you, follow the biography of the seerah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as we do know and we learn, and that's why we're sharing with you. I hope that, and I pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for us Muslims to learn from all of these when we're dealing with non-Muslims around us. Allahumma ameen, Allahumma ameen, وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات، الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين. ما من يوم جمعة إلا وفيه ساعة إجابة. ندعو الله خاشعين ضارعين أن تكون هذه الساعة اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين، وأعلي بفضلك رايتي الحق والدين، وانصرنا على عدوك وعدونا يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر من نصر أمة محمد واجعلنا منهم، واخذل من خذل أمة محمد ولا تجعلنا منهم. اللهم أصلح لنا ديننا الذي وعصمة أمرنا، وأصلح لنا دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا، وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي إليها معادنا، واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير، واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر. اللهم آمنا في روعاتنا، اللهم كن لنا ولا تكن علينا، اللهم لا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا. اللهم اشف مرضانا، اللهم اشف مرضانا، اللهم اشف مرضانا، وارحم موتانا، وارحم موتانا، وفك أسرانا، وفك أسرانا، وكن لنا ولا تكن علينا، ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا. اللهم اكشف هذه الأمة عنا، اللهم اكشف هذا البلاء عنا، اللهم اكشف هذا الابتلاء عنا يا الله يا الله. اللهم برحمتك عمنا، واكفنا شر ما أهمنا، وعلى الإيمان الكامل والكتاب والسنة توفنا، وأنت راض عنا. اغفر اللهم لنا ولآبائنا ولأمهاتنا ولأبنائنا ولأخواتنا ولإخواننا في الله تعالى، أحياء وأمواتا، ولكل المسلمين أجمعين. إلهي هذا حالنا لا يخفى عليك، إلهي هذا حالنا لا يخفى عليك، وهذا ضعفنا ظاهر بين يديك، فعاملنا بالإحسان إذ الفضل منك وإليك، واختم لنا بخاتمة السعادة أجمعين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمركم بثلاث وينهاكم عن ثلاث، إن الله يأمركم بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى، وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم، واشكروه يزدكم، قوموا إلى صلاة ظهركم يرحمني وأرحمكم الله، وأستودعكم الله. أدوا صلاة الظهر عوضا عن الجمعة إن شاء الله رب العالمين. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.